It's the middle of January, and we're in the midst of a snowstorm here in Nova Scotia. I had planned on going to the woods today to record a few videos, but decided to change things up and record a few different ones here at home. So this video will be about my outdoor-related birthday and Christmas gifts I received. If you're interested, keep watching. All right, before we get started, I just wanted to go over why I'm making this video in the first place. So I recognize just how fortunate I am that my family were generous and gave me these gifts, and I just wanted to share them with you. So this will not be a review of any of these items. I've only had them for a very short time. Yes, my birthday is in December, just before Christmas. So I haven't had them long enough to give you a review. So as a result, I'm going to give you minimal information on each of these items, just enough to see whet your appetite maybe. And my plan is at some point that I will review most of these, if not all of these items, well, after I get some experience with them, with of course. So what we'll do now is we'll just go down to my tabletop here and I'll very briefly go through each of these items before we wrap up the video. All right, so there will be no specific order to these items as I present them to you, with the exception of this first one, and only because this has already appeared in a couple of videos, as this was something I received as a birthday gift a few weeks ago. And this, of course, is the Survive Outside Longer Plasma Lighter. It's advertised as a fuel-free lighter. I'm not going to give you a whole lot of information on it because I haven't had it long enough to form any really good opinions on it, but I'll share you with you what it is in case you haven't seen it in my other videos. So the concept is that this uses a rechargeable battery to create a plasma arc across the top of those four contact points, and it is generates a very high heat intense plasma beam, or not beam, but arc, and it will light a lot of materials. And basically, I've been using it mostly with birch bark, but I've used it for lighting a few other materials. It is rechargeable, so I guess it's not totally fuel-free. Yes, there's no lighter fluid or anything, but you do have to recharge it, and there is a USB Type-A port here to recharge the internal battery on it. Let me just see if I can show you the arc. I'm not sure how well this will pick up, if it's showing on the screen that it appears to be, but I can tell you it's very effective at lighting things up. Now, it does also have a flashlight on the bottom, but that's secondary to its primary function, of course. What's really cool about it as well is that even the paracord that they sent with it as a lanyard has a center core that is a tinder-type material, so if you need something and you don't have anything else, you could pull some of the center cord out of this and use it. So I will do a review on this at some point. I just need to get some more experience with it. I want to see how long the charge lasts. It's supposed to last for 50 fires. Now that come to think of it, I may have to start over again because I don't think I've been counting how many times I've used it. But it's supposed to last for 50 fires. More importantly, though, I want to see how it performs in very cold weather. So I'll have it out over the winter and then I'll give you my thoughts on it at that point. All right, speaking of winter, the next item on the list is something that was on my wish list for a long time, to be quite honest, and this is the Zippo catalytic heater. And I say it was on my list for a wish list for a long time. It's not something I would have bought for myself, but I guess that's what gifts are all about. My wife gave me this. And a catalytic heater is very much like a cigarette lighter, I guess, except it doesn't use an open flame. It creates a high heat, well, the element right there, it gets very hot once you light it. So in order to use one of these, and again, not a review, there is material inside the base of this, very much like you'd find in any Zippo lighter, and you would fill this with lighter fluid, replace the element piece on top, put a heat source like a match or a lighter flame to that. It will start to glow red, and as it does, you put this over the top, and you can put it back in this little velour stuff sack and hang it around your neck or put it in your pocket, and it will generate a lot of heat, quite a lot of heat. Not so much that it will burn you, but you will appreciate having something like this, especially if you're sitting still for any length of time. Like, I guess if you're a hunter or a fisher, or, you know, tree stand hunting or duck blind hunting, and you're not generating a lot of heat, this will go go a long way to keeping you warm. It's a very cool item. Like I said, I wouldn't have bought it myself. Now, many years ago, I owned something. It functioned differently, but it intended the same intended purpose. And maybe you're aware of these. If you were, let me know in the comments section below. But basically, what it was was a spring-loaded clamshell kind of a thing that opened up. Mine was red. It had like a red velour material, and on the inside of it looked like fiberglass lining. And what you would do is you would take these about 4-inch long. They look like charcoal sticks, and you would light one end of it and it would start to glow, and you would place it in the fiberglass bed, close it up, and then you could put that in your pocket or in another pouch and hang it around your neck, and they would generate a lot of heat. If I recall, they lasted about 4 hours with each of these sticks, and I haven't seen them in years, although I have been told they're still in production. If you can tell me a place where I can get one, I'd be interested. I don't know that I will get one, but you know, they worked very well from what I remember. Okay, let's put that aside. So the next item, these are something my younger daughter gave me this year, and it's an S-hook, and I'll take one out of the package. It's from the Tandy Corporation. It's intended for working with leather or canvas or any other very hard, very tough materials, and this is something that I'm going to add to my repair kit, my outdoor repair kit, rather than the sail needle that you see a lot of people recommend or a lot of people are carrying. So let me give you as close up as I can of the S-hook. Little protector on the end of it. The needle end is triangular, which is very strong and produces a hole which is intended not to rip out with a lot of stress on the sides, but it's the S shape that makes it so functional. The idea being that you can place your thumb in that lower curve and you have a whole lot of grip on that to push through material. So I'm looking forward to trying these. As you can see, I haven't tried them yet at all, but from every report that I understand, these are exceptionally purposeful, very useful, I guess, and they go a long way, and I think they'll replace the sail needle, which is a little harder to get around here and a little bit more costly than I wanted to pay for it, but these were not too expensive, and they're available from the Tandy Corporation. I mean, we'll put that aside. Okay, the next item is something that I don't know that I would have purchased for myself. It was on my wish list. I was actually quite surprised when my wife bought it for me, and now I'm really looking forward to getting out and using it. You've probably already seen these or seen reviews on it. It's the Bitty Big Q barbecue grill pot support, whatever else you want to call it. I haven't even used it, as you can tell, but I'll give you an idea of how it is intended to be used. So basically, it folds up to a very compact size. It does have a bit of weight. I'm going to say 2.5 pounds, but I'll give you more details at some point. And the concept here is that you open it up, not once but twice. And that is the width of the grill, and so it's already got a lot of surface area for using, but on each corner there is fold-out legs. Each of these legs folds out once, twice, and three times. I won't fold all four of them out, but you can see that will allow me three height adjustments that I can set this over a fire or whatever else I'm using. And the last thing that this grill does is that it expands in this direction. So that is a huge amount of surface area for placing pots on or steaks or sausages or whatever else you want to cook directly over your heat source. In fact, you can get a number of things on here at the same time. So let me just put this away when you're all finished. Now, this does come with a little scraper that you can use for cleaning the stainless steel grill off. From everything I've seen about these are well-reviewed, very durable, very functional. We'll see. I'll get it out and I'll play with it. And after I get some experience with it, then I'll bring it back and share my thoughts on it. All right, so along the lines of cooking, the next three items I wanted to share with you are all from the same maker. I receive all three of these from different members of my family and for both birthday and Christmas. So let me start with the first one. And this is from Sea to Summit. This is from their X series lineup and their lightweight silicone collapsible lineups. And this is their kettle. Now, let me just quickly demonstrate how this works and then I'll talk a little bit more about it. So basically, it's a collapsible kettle like that. There is the kettle fully assembled. Now, what makes this kind of unique is, of course, it's very lightweight, and when it's collapsed down, it's very compact. It has a hard anodized aluminum base. It has a Lexan top on it, fold away handles, and these are designed, when they're collapsed, to nest with the rest of the series or other items in the series. So I have a video where I reviewed the X series coffee pour over device. I didn't give it a great review, and I'll let you go back and see the reason why. It just didn't function as well as I think it was intended to, but that's okay. Now, it is intended that the mug or the coffee maker or whatever will fit inside of this. This will fit inside of their pots, and they'll all fit inside of a pan that you can purchase as well. My interest in these items started with my daughter giving me a eating set about 6 years ago, my older daughter. So in that set came a good sized plate with collapsible silicone side, as well as a bowl and a mug. And I've had that for a number of years and used it numerous times. They've appeared in a number of videos. So it's kind of cool to have the complete set. So probably what I'll do at some point is go out for a day and do all my cooking and show you all the items at the same time. So far, what I can say about them is I like it. I have not used it, as you can see, but I have no doubt that the quality meets with the other items from this series that I've used already. Okay, the next item is also from Sea to Summit, and it's a completely different item for them. So Sea to Summit has two more lines, or they probably have more than that, but at least two more lines of cooking implements, and they are the Sigma series and the Alpha series. And the Alpha series are hard anodized aluminum, and the Sigma series are lightweight stainless steel. And this is the Sigma 1.9 liter pot. And I'll tell you right now, for a pot of this size, this is without question the lightest pot in my whole collection. Again, I have not used it, so I can't tell you too much about it, but I can share a few of the features. So again, one of the things I like about it is the fact that it is stainless steel and very tough, and also, but exceptionally lightweight for the fact that it is stainless steel. So some of the more outstanding features obviously are the base. Now, this is some type of a painted on surface, very much like a high heat resistant barbecue paint that you can get. And the intended reason for it is two things. One is that it will absorb radiant heat better, but two, it does have some texture, and that's intended to prevent or lessen the chances of it sliding when you have this on top of a gas or an alcohol stove. There is the lid, of course, does have drain holes here and a single one here, but what really makes this stand out as being different is the way the handle works. Instead of the fold over the top that you see many other pots have, this one has a swing out handle and a locking mechanism to hold it in place so it doesn't collapse on you unintentionally. It seems to work very well. I haven't had a chance to try it, but one of the other things I like about it is the little holder in the center. This also is made of silicone, allows you to get a hold of it with your fingers. You don't have to rely on a fork or stick or something else to slip through a D-ring to take it off, and you can get a hold of it because it's silicone, you won't burn yourself. But on the inside of that, there is a little flap of silicone material, and that's intended to sit on the side of the pot, so you don't have to lay your pot covered down on the ground. So two more quick features I want to share with you. Hopefully this will show up. Inside are volume graduation marks on the inside to give you a better idea of how much water or whatever else you have inside of this. And the final thing is, they even thought to design the base to make it easier for you to clean everything out. So the base is rounded to fit most spoons or something similar to clean out the base. So I think that's a kind of unique feature. Once again, no experience with it, but if it's like anything, everything else I have from Sea to Summit, I have no question that the quality is there. So I eventually will bring that back to you. One more item from Sea to Summit, another gift to me, a fry pan. So what makes this fry pan different is this is made from hard anodized aluminum. It's a good size for one, maybe two people, but definitely a good size for me, I think, anyway. And as I mentioned, exceptionally lightweight, and it has fold-out handles on the sides. So it compacts down a little bit. And this also is intended to nest with the other items from the X series. So I've actually can fit my pot and my kettle and my everything right inside of this. And I think that's a kind of a cool feature. If you're wondering, you can take these handles off, and I may do that, and I'll explain why in a minute. So I did see in some of the reviews on this that people were complaining that food that they cooked was sticking to the bottom of it, especially eggs. And I can understand that because, you know, if you don't use a good amount of fat like oil or butter or something in your pan, then eggs tend to stick to a lot of things. But what's neat about this is the fact that it is hard anodized aluminum means that you can season it just like you would a carbon steel or a cast iron fry pan. In fact, if you're likely aware, is that Steve Despain from the Firebox Stove does offer for sale some pans and their cooking sets that are made of hard anodized aluminum, and he provides instructions on how to season them. So you can do very much the same thing with this. And if you wanted to remove the handles because you didn't want to have them exposed to flames, you can do that, but then you'd have to have a pot grabber of some type to grab onto the sides of it. So I'm looking forward to getting this seasoned up and taking it out and using this in the woods as well. It is light. That's one of the things I think I appreciate most about this, as well as the size. All right, now, speaking of fry pans and seasoning, check this out. Boy, this is so big it barely fits in the camera. So my wife was shopping for a gift for someone else over Christmas at a restaurant supply place, and she spotted this. This is a carbon steel French style fry pan, and again, it was a restaurant supply place. I'm not sure if these are available everywhere, but I will give you the link to where she picked this one up. Look at the size of this pan. This is huge. It's got to be every bit of 12 inches across the top. But for the size of it, it's exceptionally lightweight. And it's, you know, if you're familiar, carbon steel is almost as good, for most people will say, as good as a cast iron fry pan, but a lot more durable. But in order to use them and get the most from it, you have to season these as well. As you can see, this is unseasoned, brand new, no seasoning applied to this at all. Honestly, this is not something I'm going to take with me a lot into the woods. I'll take it car camping. I may use it at home, but it won't go with me a lot in the woods unless I've got a lot that I want to cook up or there's more than one of us going out at the same time. But very inexpensive, which is what surprised me. And she saw it as an extra. She bought it for me. I really appreciate it. But again, I have not had a chance to use it. Okay, the last two things I want to share with you is our pair of books that I was given. Now, I love receiving books. I love purchasing books. And I'm very much of the school of the more you know, the less you carry. And of course, that's from Morris Kahansky. The more you know, the less you carry. Because truly, bushcraft is more than just the kit. It's the both the knowledge and the skills. And one of the best ways that I know of attaining knowledge and skills, apart from YouTube, which of course a lot of us, and in fact you're watching it right now, is from books like these. So these two books are by the Scandinavian author and legendary outdoors person Lars Fult. And they are the Outdoors, the Scandinavian Way, Summer Edition and Winter Edition. So I've only begun going through these two books, so I can't tell you a whole lot about them, other than the fact that they are jam-packed with useful information, some of which I knew, but a lot of which was new to me. Not all of it is applicable to my situation here in Nova Scotia, but that's the point about these books. It's how they do it in Scandinavia. I'm looking forward to going through them. What I can tell you so far is there are a lot of drawings as well as written information in each of these books and just very enjoyable reading. So I think what I'll do at some point when I've gone through these books in greater detail is maybe I'll bring them back and share my thoughts on them. In fact, I have a whole library of books that I would like to share my thoughts on with you at some point. What I will do, however, is I'll provide you the link where these books were purchased from in case you're interested in purchasing any of these yourself. So it turns out there was one more Christmas gift that I wanted to share with you. And it's funny that I had forgotten this because I consider this one of the most important pieces of outdoor gear that I take with me every trip, and that is a watch. Now, before I show you the new one, and I just wanted to quickly show you this. This is a Timex Expedition watch that I wore for at least 27 years on patrol. It recently died. I think it was probably early December when it stopped working. I had replaced the battery and that was the end of it. It never worked again. But 27 years of patrol duty and then wearing it out in the woods for the last almost seven years that I've been retired, I would say that I have a lot of faith in Timex watches. The strap has obviously been replaced as well. What do you think? When I went to get a new watch or when I asked for a new watch, what do you think I asked for? Another Timex watch, because I have that much faith. You know, you can spend a lot more on a watch than you do on these Timex watches, but for my needs, I don't think I could do any better. So this is my new replacement watch, also a Timex Expedition, a bit updated. It, very simple watch. What I especially like about this one is the white hands on the black face. It makes it just so easy to see, you know, at a distance without having to put a pair of glasses on. And it does have the indigo lighting, so by pressing the little date adjust there and the winding knob, it's actually, you don't wind because they're electric now, it does glow in the dark. So it's everything I need. Now, if I get as long out of this watch as I did out of this old one, this will probably be the last watch I ever buy. Yes, you can spend a lot more on a watch, but I just couldn't see it for myself. So I appreciate that my wife, I think this is one of the first things she bought for me this year after this one died. So I just wanted to share that with you as well. Well, I've hoped you enjoyed this video and allowed me to share with you the birthday and Christmas gifts that I were given this year. And really, there's one other reason for me making this video, and that is I'm interested in knowing whether or not, first off, do you have any of these items? Do you own them now? What are your thoughts on them? As I mentioned in the opening, I do plan on doing a review on these items at some point when I get some experience with them. So your thoughts would be of interest to me as well. Are you planning on buying any of these yourself? And just let me know that as well, because I'm kind of interested in knowing what other people think of these items. For the most part, I haven't seen a lot of reviews on these items, well, with the exception of a few of them. So yeah, I'll take all that information into account when eventually I do the reviews. Okay, so once again, thank you for joining me on this alternate video because of the storm day that we're having outside. And until I see you again, get out and explore and take that path less traveled, because it will make all the difference. Bye for now.